BKW Physics. I'm Mr. McClellan. I'm going to do a little summary of some of the graph concepts that we've been talking about over the course of the last week or so. And my class has a quiz coming up, so they're just trying to prepare for that. And I'm just summarizing the different things that we've talked about. So if I start with some distance-time graphs, I'll start with two of them. One that goes like this and one that goes like this. Now, if I were putting in words what was happening here in terms of distance, you'd say, well, as time goes on, the distance is getting long. As time goes on, the distance is staying the same. That's easy for most people to do. What's hard for a lot of people to do is say, what does that mean about the velocity? So, if the distance is getting less, what is happening to the speed in this scenario? The answer is, the speed is staying the same. So velocity is the same. Because it's a straight line, because it's linear. Okay? The only time the velocity is changing, actually, is if you see a curve. And if you see a curve, your velocity is changing. So what's happening to this one? This one, the velocity is the same. This one, the velocity is changing. This one, the velocity is
staying the same.
Zero. Zero. Not moving. Velocity is zero. This is what's hard for physics students to do. That's why I'm asking you to review this and think about this again. I know you can look at these and tell me what's happening to the distance. I'm not sure you can look at these and tell me what's happening to the velocity. So those are kind of the words that match up to what's happening here. In any case, if we took any of these, well, kind of ignore the last one because it's curved. Took the first two. If we took the slope of either one of the first two, what would we get? Slope of the distance time graph gives us velocity. Okay? Probably, you can't really take the slope of the curve, but if we took one point, we could get the instantaneous velocity. If we could do velocity of distance divided by time for that one spot. Okay? We could do distance to kind of get velocity for that one spot, but it wouldn't tell us the trend. When we do the slope, it tells us the trend. Alright. So let's use this graph and let's draw one more that looks similar to it. This one. So I'm focusing my attention on these two now. If I look at this one here, my velocity is changing again. In what way? Am I decreasing my velocity or increasing my velocity? And the dead giveaway, if you're not picking up on the difference here, the dead giveaway is that look at what happens to the distance at the end. It gets flat. When the distance gets flat, what did that mean back here? You're getting like a zero velocity, right? So you're going from, I have a velocity, I have less velocity, I have no velocity. So in other words, when you look at this picture, you can kind of see, because it's flattening out, that your velocity is changing, it's actually decreasing. Is that clear? So, take another scenario. I shouldn't have to do it as slow this time. What's happening down here? Velocity is zero. So you're increasing here. This is velocity changing, but this is an increasing. Make sense? Alright. So that's just like knowing where to look, having the right eye, you know, having your physics eye on. Your physics eye is kind of like this. You squint one and you make the other big. Alright, that's your physics eye. Your physics eye is going to notice stuff like that. Not both. Okay. So then we move into, let's just change gears and make these velocity time graphs. Let's do kind of, I'll try to do it the same. I got velocity time, velocity time. I make one go like that, and I make another go like this. All of you are like, well, I know this means the velocity is slowing down. This means the velocity is staying the same. I'm like, good. Well, I want to know by looking at these what's happening to acceleration. Okay, because talking about the velocity is easy if it's the velocity kind of graph. Talking about the acceleration is harder. If your velocity is changing, are you accelerating?
Yes.
Okay, so we're accelerating. Agreed. If your velocity is getting less, what can you say about the acceleration? So you have negative acceleration. Does that... Can you have negative acceleration and be speeding up? How?
If you're going backwards.
Yeah, it's a directional thing. So this has a dual, it could be a dual meaning type of thing. It could mean you're slowing down, and it could mean you're just going backwards, speeding up. Because in both cases, you'll get a negative. That's a good point. Right here, what's happening to your acceleration? And what is it? It is same, but what is the number? Yeah, it's an acceleration of zero. It's accelerating to zero because it's staying the same speed. So what are the two things that could be happening? Well, your velocity could be a zero. You could be like not moving. That's the picture, as long as that number is zero. Or this could be 100, and you're just going along at 100, at 100, at 100. Still got an acceleration of zero. See how that works? Alright. What about this one? Oh, by the way, we don't do curve velocity time graphs. Not that they don't exist, but they just seem to be too hard for high school physics, so we don't do that. Okay? So we don't do curved velocity time graphs. But if we were to take the slope of these, what would it give us? Acceleration. That's why I've been talking about acceleration. And the other thing is, if we were to take the area underneath the line, we get a distance. So a lot of you are starting to really wrap your mind around that concept. One other thing I just wanted to, it's not confusing with, but point out, is if this is a velocity time graph and that's zero right there, and we have one where it goes real fast, and I label this A, I label this B, and I label down there C. Let's break it into pieces and talk about what's happening in each piece. During AB, what's going on in terms of acceleration? Yeah, you're doing the negative acceleration like the first. What happens at B? You stop. See, because your velocity is now zero, so you stop. And then what happens B to C?
So negative acceleration.
It's got more acceleration. Is it positive or negative?
Negative.
let's put some numbers to this. Say this number right here is a negative 2 on the velocity scale. Say this number down here is a 4 on the velocity scale. So if we're doing acceleration, it's the change in velocity over time. It's final minus initial velocity. Final velocity is a negative 4. The initial velocity is a negative, like that, you know, right? So whatever the time is, we'll just leave it as t. What's this going to give us? Give us a negative. So it's still going to be a
negative
acceleration. But this is that scenario. It's like for the other reason. You know what I mean? Because this would be like a scenario where, you throw something up in the air. It goes up, it comes down. As on the way up, it's accelerating, it's slowing down. On the way down, it's accelerating, speeding up. But either way, you're going to get a negative number when you do it. Not too much for you? This is kind of touches on all the things you need to know for that quiz that I was talking about with my class tomorrow. These are kind of some basic graphing principles. So for today, just